said, seriously, and I did my best. I've taken the liberty of sharing with everyone about 14 different documents because I wanted everyone to have the same thing. And Kevin, I apologize. I've been flooding the city clerk and lawyer with different pieces of information.
No, that's weird. Don't apologize. That's fine. It's a good, well, I got them tonight, so I haven't read them yet.
Not at all. I wanted to say, I'll say it very quickly. Mary, you mentioned that I've been working with Long Branch for a long time. I've had the privilege of serving as a volunteer and as a paid nonprofit person since 1970. First working with substance abusers and their families, and then setting up mentoring with Monmouth College University kids at the Housing Authority for those youngsters. And then I was director of Human Services in Red Bank, working very closely with your Department of Human Services when we still had that. And indeed, the Long Branch Concordance, and it's gone through certain iterations, but it's still safe that it has served thousands of people. So I'm much more used to giving help than I am requesting it. So I feel a little awkward doing it. What I'm trying to do is specifically answer your question in a very consistent form. And first, I have the letters to yourself, which you'll read when you get the chance, because I know you're very busy.
I'll read them in the next day or so, I'm sure.
And to you, John, I really appreciate your help. Then, in line with what other places are doing, for example, Asbury Park and the city of Camden, just two examples, is I have for you my handicap license, which I got from DMV. Second is a letter from my psychiatrist attesting to why this is so important to me. Thirdly, a letter from my primary care physician explaining that between, frankly, the PTSD and my back problems, I'm not kidding, I really need your help. Then the apartment that I'm going to be moving into on February 14th, it's Valentine's Day. That's really close. I need to get myself settled as quickly as I can. I have a letter from a discussion I had with a representative from the Americans with Disabilities Department of Justice in Washington, D.C., explaining that indeed there are no prohibitions at all in terms of specific resident handicapped parking. I have the New Jersey code that explains the background for all of the examples of designated handicapped parking that is used in the state. I have a letter from January 17th when I spoke specifically to Michael Manzella, transportation manager, City of Asbury Park, in which he explained quite specifically there is resident handicap on street parking in Asbury Park for renters specifically designated for particular handicapped individuals. And their process is clearly obvious. So that's very local. I have a copy of the ordinance from the Borough of Deal, which went through quite recently, I understand. In fact, was adopted on June 9th, 2017. I have ordinance information from Middletown Township about specific locations. I went outside our area a little bit, and I have...
Ms. Blair, you have 1 minute.
Yes, sir. I have information about resident handicap on-street parking from the city of Camden. I have contact information from the Americans with Disabilities. If anyone should want to call and speak with their technical assistance line, I'm more than welcome to do so. And then I have the New Jersey Guide to Accessible Parking. So.
The last one was included in the working time.
Yes.
Yes, it was. Mary was very helpful helping me get it all together. So
okay.
I hope this is enough of a basis. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Garrett.